like this from chat, so I'll ask it. I don't normally, because chat usually, you know, good for spamming, not good for posing questions. But would you rather have 100 Thieves Poe Belter, or would you rather have 100 Thieves Best Academy Mid Palafox? Fox?
Depends on what you want.
Poe Belter is a lot better.
Yeah, it depends on what you want. Like, if you want to take another development year, if you think that it's completely doomed for next year, I think you can take a chance.
What but is like, development years, man? I hate this. I hate it.
I think giving a completely fresh player a chance in LCS, like, I think that you can actually like get experience from it. So for example, like a development year to me would be like kind of like Demonte did last year. I think Demonte is like substantially better this year than he was last year. And a lot of people remember like when he kind of went the like I'm gonna be useful route of playing things like
10 minutes,
like Qiyana. Yeah, and like Rumble mid, it just like all bunch of weird stuff at the end of last year to try to like remain relevant. So like now he can actually like play more of like the Syndra lane phases into some of the top players, and like it's not like auto lost from that perspective. So I think that like giving a player like a chance and like having them find their footing, like it's not really like a development year. It's like just giving a player some time to like actually adapt to being like an LCS player. Like I think that right now I'd probably rather have somebody like Demonte on my team than Poe Belter. Like I think that, you know, there's more upside to the way that Demonte plays the game. He's more active on the map, better roaming. Obviously, he's better teammates, so it's hard to say. But I do think that like he's a player that seems like he's adapted well to LCS. So that's like what I'm defining as a development year, something like that.
Okay. All right. I'm most afraid of for like development year terms is like I think people greatly overestimate how much time it actually takes to become good if you really know what you're doing, at least to contend at like a serviceable level. And so one of the things that I'm most afraid of is like people that have been around the scene for multiple years at like academy or third league level, they're not magically going to flip a switch, right? And I think that I would use China and Korea's systems as an argument against that. Like look at Closer, look at Caria, look at so many of the LCK rookies that they have no competitive experience and they're going up against way stronger opponents and they're still serviceable. And you can bet your ass they would be more than serviceable in North America if they just were dropped into a laning phase or something, right, against different players. So the problem is the foundation is moldy. So if the foundation isn't fixed, you're essentially putting fresh fruit on top and you're praying for the best. And I don't think that is, like, a healthy option. So when all that you're left with is, like, decisions between, like, Palafox and Poe Belter, it's always just going to be take Poe Belter because he's more resistant to the mold than, you know, like a player that could just be another question mark and then you can have another thrown away year. At least that's how I look at it.
I mean, it's just like for me, if I see like people like that never get a chance, it's like, so what exactly do you want the academy system to do? If a player can get rank one in solo queue, win academy one split, like right, get first in academy the next split, like what exactly can a player do? Like, and he's like pretty much like the star of his team in academy. Like he's the hard carry of his team. I mean, obviously Fudge is good too. Like the whole team is solid, but the point is like, he's one of the better pieces of his team. What does a player do then to prove themselves within like the competition we have? Because in regional leagues, these players would get chances, right? Somebody performs this well, somebody goes to EU Masters and just dicks EU Masters to fucking, splits in a row. They're getting some shots. Yeah. They're getting some shots.
Like, so one of the things I really hope for, and I hope Riot fucking actually does something, is please, for the love of God, have a Kespa Cup in North America. Let the Academy teams go up against the LCS teams and let people qualify for this tournament. So that third league players,
Maryville University, Radiance,
maybe, maybe you know, they're not friends with some people on Academy, so they can't actually get chances, get in. You know what I mean? Yep. And they can show things. There are lots of iconic like Korean and Chinese players that actually played in third leagues that couldn't get on teams, but once they played in the Kespa Cup or like the third league thing, made it straight to debut teams. But nepotism is just, it's so gross, man. It's a fucking...
What was it? Those are the era of like Zenix Storm and Zenix... what was the other one? Zenix Boom? Was that the other one?
Yeah.
I mean, Khan's big debut was on a KG team.
Who?
Like, Khan.
No, what was the name of the team?
He played in Kespa Cup. KG is a regional league in Korea that still is hosted.
Oh. Below they allow.
I've never watched one match of it.
Yeah, dude, okay. that's a deep cut.
KEG teams can legitimately beat certain KEG teams can legitimately beat like top Challenger Korea and like bottom LCK teams. Depending on like who their rosters are, like who the players are, but they just can't debut because of contracts. And then you never hear about them. But the same thing happens in China. China has third leagues, so the same thing happens. And some of these teams actually play against each other in like Asia events. They like travel or they like play online. And some of the players are fucking insane. But you never hear about them. It's sort of like how Gen G has four teams.
The AD carry of Sunning, God. Or however the fuck you pronounce it. Now. I watch it muted, but maybe it's Suning, maybe it's Sunning, whatever.
I hope Tyler does something.
That AD carry is
like,
insane.
With TCS this year. Like last year, TCS allowed Academy players to play, right? Almost. Mm-hmm. Or they did. Like there was like a rule, right?
Yep.
I hope to God Riot does something with Tyler this year. I'll fucking... I don't know if I can help in some way, but like, holy shit. There needs to be a Kespa Cup in North America. There has to be fucking something.
Yeah. Isn't it crazy that the TCS is doing a better job developing talent?
Tyler no, we was... need Tyler, man.
I want to push back on that.
Holy shit, he's got to save it.
Tyler is doing a better job. Tyler's doing a better job showcasing talent. He's not developing talent. He's showcasing talent.
Yeah.
Like, let's not take away that much from the orgs and from the universities and from these third-party teams that have, like, a coach and analyst, right? Like, I don't want to take that.